Hello everyone, welcome back to Orlando Short Sale Expert.info. My name is Mark Allen Adams. I'm a licensed real estate agent with Keller Williams Realty, and I own and operate a team of real estate professionals that specialize in short sales. We are in the trenches every single day talking to lenders and getting deficiency judgments waived and getting properties sold in which more is owed than what the property is actually worth. And we try and video blog on a consistent basis, trying to get good, relevant, and current information out to you, the public. Perhaps you're sitting in front of your computer right now, you're upside down on your property, you're experiencing some kind of financial hardship, or maybe you're just upside down and tired of throwing good money after bad. We're glad that you're here today, and we've created quite a library, a very substantial library of videos. I'm sure you can find whatever questions you have, I'm sure you can find an answer somewhere on this site. And today we're keeping it simple. We're talking about how a short sale works exactly. What are the steps involved and how does it work? Well, number one, you have to be upside down on your property. You have to owe more on your property than what the property would actually bring on today's open market. So that's step number one. Step number two is you have to list your property on the open market. You have to hire a real estate agent to do it. Banks are going to want to see that you marketed the property on the MLS. They're going to want to see that you were aggressive. You know, they want to know that whoever you hired tried to get the best price possible, the highest amount possible on the open market. So that's step number two. Now the next step is to collect a short sale package. And what that is it's bank statements, it's pay stubs, it's a hardship letter, it's your tax returns. It's a whole big stack of paperwork. And so then, you know, after we market the property, we get an offer, we get all of that paperwork and we send it into your lender. And if there's multiple lenders, we send it into all parties involved. You know, sometimes there's an HOA that has a lien on the property, and there's a first and a second, and sometimes even a third. We've pretty much seen it all, we think. One time we actually had a water filtration company that had a lien on a property that we had to deal with. But so then that's the next step. Then the lenders all analyze the offer, they analyze your situation, they go out and they do their own appraisal on the property, and they deem whether the offer is reasonable enough. They look at your income, they look at your financial position, and they factor that into the equation on, you know, whether they're going to ask for cash at closing, whether they're going to let you go free and clear. And so they're going to look at all those things. And then you go to the closing table. Once a decision's made, you go to the closing table. Let me back up one step. You're going to get a short sale approval letter. Once all parties involved, all your lenders have signed off on it, they're going to issue what's called a short sale approval letter. And in that letter, they're going to basically tell you the terms of the approval. And they're going to tell you, Mr. Smith, we accept this short sale, but, you know, we want X amount of money at closing. Usually it's a couple thousand bucks. Or they'll say, go in peace, you know, sin no more. We will accept your short sale and let you walk away free and clear. But anyway, you'll know, the bottom line is you'll know before you go to the closing table what the lender's terms are. And that's a big relief to a lot of people, because you don't want to get to the closing table and agree to terms that don't work for you. It's short sales, a lot of times the business decision. And if it doesn't work for you, if the terms don't work for you, you know, you have an opportunity to back out. Then if you agree to the terms, go to the closing table, and it's like a traditional real estate transaction. You sign a bunch of paperwork, you turn over the keys to the new owner, and everybody parts ways. And hopefully the short sale went smoothly, and you got some relief. You got some financial relief and got out from underneath a property that was weighing you down, and it was a bad asset, and it got it off your books. So that's the nuts and bolts of it. For more information about short sales, go ahead and click the link directly to the right of this video. Contact us if you have any more questions. There is no question that's too small. There's no obligation. We're just here to give free advice. So go ahead and click that link to the right of this video now. If you're on YouTube, click the link directly below this video, and they'll take you to our homepage where you can contact us. Have a great day.